Hey coding owls, welcome back to the channel. This video I am specifically creating for solving a problem which is connecting your Apache Superset with Oracle DB. Now if you go to Superset documentation for Oracle, you will find they have just given you a simple trick here. What is that? Please go to Oracle and download this particular. This is the URL, but the library recommended is CX underscore Oracle. But the problem is CX underscore Oracle is discontinued and Oracle DB is the new approved driver which is available for Superset. So I was struggling a lot with this issue. I solved it. I thought I'll just create a video. It will be helpful for you. So what exactly are we doing here is I have a Superset which is running in Docker container, which is running on port 8088. Then I have Oracle, which is running in different container on port 1521 with username, system, password, my password 123. And then again, I have a Docker container for my Oracle as well. So what I have done is I've combined them both into one Docker Compose file, and I'm trying to run it with one additional step here. You can find all these files on my GitHub repository. I will just post the link in the chat window. So here, what has happened? Sorry, I'll put it in description. So here I have created a Docker Compose file, and in the Docker Compose file, the first thing I'm starting is my Oracle XE, which is the Oracle container, which is running Oracle XE 1521 password. And then I'm doing a health check. Then I am running a Superset build, but this time I am executing it from a Docker file, which is inside my Superset folder. So here, if you see my Docker file, you will find I am loading it from Apache Superset, the latest, and I am installing Oracle DB inside it. Plus, I am also passing a Superset config file, which is doing what? Which is installing Oracle DB, but it is passing, it's like renaming or letting my container know that I am using CX Oracle, because that is what Superset will understand, or whenever they want to work with Superset, that is what they'll look for. But behind the pictures, we are passing Oracle DB. So if you go to the Docker Compose file, what will you find is you have Superset, container name is Superset. I am using the external port as 8089 because I have another Superset running on 8088. So that's fine. You can just make it 8088. Then I am loading my Superset config file, and I am also loading all the volumes. I am like Superset folder, I am uploading it. And then I say it depends upon Oracle XE. And then I create like basic Superset command. So like admin will be the username, and it will start. So I will open my folder where this all files are, from where my repository is also running. And I will, if you're doing this for first time, just open your making. Obviously we'll have Docker loaded. So I'll say Docker Compose up and hyphen hyphen build. So what this will do at this particular time for me is it will download, if you are doing for first time, it was already running for me. So it got downloaded quite quickly. See, so it is showing me that my Oracle is running. Okay, this step will need some time. Once it stops, okay. Now I will go back and I'll open my localhost 8089 because I am running it on 8089. I think they need some more time to complete it. This step you'll have to wait and make sure that everything works fine. Okay, so be patient here, 2-3 minutes. Yeah, see, once I start, it will, because I already logged in, it was from my cache, it took the connection. And now see, there is no database connected right now. If I go and click on updates and see, if you find Oracle here, that means your step has been successfully completed and you will be able to now pass the Oracle Alchemy URL. Now this URI is very important. The one you find on internet is not something which will always work for you. So at this point, you will have to go and change the like URL, and the URL will look something like this. See, let me just format the URL for you. Here it is, Oracle plus CX Oracle. Our username is system and our password is my password 123. Then you pass the name of the container and 1521. So if you are using, let's say internally you are using something else, please pass that internal one here, and your service name will be XCPDB. So after I do that and I pass it here, if I say test connection, it says connection looks good. Believe me, to find this particular thing, this particular toast here, it took me a lot of time. It was only giving Oracle spec, not specified. And then I connected here. Once I connect, see, after that, Superset works very clearly. You don't have to worry about anything. You will select your Oracle DB. And now at this point, I don't have anything. So let me, I'm using DBviewer and I was previously having other databases. I'll quickly just delete them, which were running here. Let me just delete it and create a new one for us. Okay. So I'll create a new connection, go to Oracle. And here I will say XCPDB1 and name is user, that is my system, and password is going to be what? My password 123. Then I test my connection. It will, if you're doing this for first time, it will ask you for downloads. Download that. I finish it. Once I finish, let me create schema is like a user. So let me, for I have kept the queries for it. And if you want, I can pass this query also in the Git repo. So here we will do what? Quickly just create a new SQL editor. I will open a new script. And this is my first script. Okay. I created a test user. Then I grant the privileges. The software I'm using is called DBviewer. It's very famous software. So I queried one by one. Okay. And then I will unlock that account. And now if you refresh, you will see that test user is already here. I open my script, new script on test user. And I start creating the table, and let me insert some value also into it. So I'll copy this quickly, go there, paste it, run the query for the table, add the values, add other values. Okay, I'm taking just 4 or 5 values quickly. Better would have been, I would have taken a SQL file and imported it. Okay. So that's good enough. I have got test user now. Under my test user, I have got employees table. And in my table, I have got 6 records. Now I want to see whether these records are getting replicated there. So I reload and I go to now test user. And inside test user, I find employees. And inside employees, I'll just say create. Consider I just want to create a big number, want to see how many records are there. So we have got 6 records. I'll just quickly select simple and let's say ID, and I want the count. Okay, save. And if I create chart, it should say 6, and I'll say 6 employees. So this is how you can connect your Oracle database to your Superset. Simple steps. You can find the link to the Git repository in the description. Thank you for watching this video. Please do subscribe.